Much of human behavior can be explained by watching wild beasts around us. They are constantly teaching us things about ourselves and the way of the universe. But most people are too blind to watch and listen. Too blind that we have at many times mistaken animals for other species. Well, this particular episode dubbed Spot the Difference is a guide of sorts, giving you tips on how not to make that mistake again and making sure that you call each animal by its right name. My name is Shaban and this is ECOZONE. Da-da-da-da-da! Gorillas and chimpanzees. Now, a lot of people will dispute it when scientists say that humans and apes are close cousins of sorts. Crazy, right? Well, the genetic material of apes is identical to that of humans to a very, very large degree. Now, humans and chimps share 98.7 similar DNA, whereas gorillas share about 98%. Although chimpanzees are the closest relatives to humans, gorillas resemble us in more aspects. For instance, the gorilla's hands and feet resemble that of humans one more than any other ape. Now, gorillas spend more time on the ground than any other ape, and that is probably why they are more suited to walking, just like humans. But hey, there's more classic differences between the gorilla and the chimpanzee, coming right up.
Body size and structure. Starting from the body size, gorillas are larger than twice the size of a chimpanzee. Adult male silverbacks are 1.5 to 1.8 meters tall, weigh between 140 to 200 kilograms. Usually, an adult female is about half of the size of a silverback. Adult male chimpanzees in standing position can measure about 1.2 meters tall and can weigh between 35 to 70 kilograms. On the other hand, female chimpanzees can stand at around 1 meter tall and weigh between 26 to 50 kilograms. A chimpanzee's ears are large and stick out of the head, which is a distinctive character from other larger primates. Gorillas' ears, on the other hand, are small and direct towards the back of the head. The head, forehead, and hump of gorillas are larger, whereas those of chimpanzees are much smaller. Body color. Mountain gorillas have black or brown-gray fur with black skin on chests, palms, and faces. Males acquire silver-gray saddles across their backs and upper thighs at sexual maturity, earning them the name silverback. This silver-gray area breaks up their overall dark coloration, creating an optical illusion of increased length and larger size. Instead of having fur, the body of a chimpanzee is mostly covered with long black hair and sometimes can also have mustaches on their chin. Their whole body is hairy except their ears, faces, palms of the hand, as well as the sole of the feet, which are bare skin. The color of their bare skin varies. It can either be black or pink. The infant chimpanzees have a skin that is very pale and tail tuft that is white. However, these physical features disappear when they finally reach early adulthood. Brain size. Both of them are primates and have larger brains. However, chimpanzees have the bigger brain and smaller body size compared to gorillas. Chimpanzees are the most intelligent in the animal kingdom other than humans, as they have the second largest brain compared to the body size. The cranial capacity of the common chimpanzees is around 320 to 480 cubic centimeters. The volume within the skull of chimpanzees is smaller than humans, but large enough to solve the problems that occur in their natural habitat. This means chimpanzees are more intelligent than gorillas. Locomotion. Both gorillas and chimpanzees are quadrupedal. They walk on all four. Their food requirements take them long distances on the ground and into the trees. But whereas the gorilla is essentially terrestrial, climbing trees with caution, chimpanzees are best characterized as arboterrestrial, being equally at home and skillful in the trees as on the ground. And in fact, in the Budongo forest, they were observed to spend about 75% of their time in the trees. Branchiation is found in the chimpanzees, but not in the gorillas. Swinging and leaping from branch to branch is a feature of chimpanzee behavior, but not of gorillas. Hanging from thin branches by one or more limbs, with the body dangling down, is a typical feeding position of the chimpanzees. On the ground, both species support the front of the body upon the knuckles and the rear of the body on the flat soles of the feet. In the trees, the hallux is abducted to grip the branch or trunk in both species. On stouter branches, the knuckles are used for support, while on thin ones and when climbing vertically, the long hand is used to grasp. Diet. Both gorillas and chimpanzees show a marked adaptability to different foods in different parts of their range, and this is true whether the same foods are available in different areas or not. Gorillas depend on a herbivorous diet. They eat close to some 200 types of leaves, tubers, flowers, fruits, fungus, and some insects. Favorite foods include bamboo, thistles, and wild celery. Gorillas do not drink water. They obtain all the moisture they need from the vast amounts of foliage they consume. Chimpanzees are primarily fruit eaters, hungrily feed on fruits, their principal diet, and on leaves, birds, and blossoms. After a while, their feeding becomes more selective, and they will choose only the ripest fruits. They usually pick fruits with their hands, but they eat berries and seeds directly off of the stem with their lips. Their diet consists of up to 80 different plant foods. Like humans, chimpanzees are omnivores. They supplement their diets with meat, such as young antelopes or goats. Their most frequent victims, however, are other primates, such as young baboons, colobus monkeys, and blue monkeys. Nesting behavior. Gorillas build large nests on the ground. The nests are used periodically both during the day and during the night. In fact, most of their time is spent either eating or sleeping. Young gorillas sometimes climb when they are playing, but the adults are too heavy to climb trees. In the rare instances when gorillas build nests in the trees, they are usually built close to the ground. Chimps spend much of their time climbing in trees, and they sleep alone every night in nests that they make with branches and leaves. While they spend equal time on land and in trees, they do most of their feeding and sleeping in trees. The basic construction of nests by both species is similar, but the chimpanzee often finishes its nest by adding a lining of leaves and branchlets, while the gorillas do not. Social structure. Mountain gorillas live in groups called troops, composed of about 10 to 15 members. A typical group consists of one silverback, one immature silverback, one immature male, 3 to 4 adult females, and 3 to 6 youngsters under 8 years old. Chimpanzees live in communities of about 30 to 80 individuals. These large groups are made up of smaller, very flexible groups of just a few animals, perhaps all females, all males, or a mixed group. Mountain gorillas have a lifespan of 30 to 40 years in the wild. During their lifespan, a female goes through a gestation period of 8 months and gives birth every 3 to 4 years. Infants stay with their mothers for 3 to 4 years. Females mature at 10 to 12 years, males at 11 to 13 years, sometimes sooner if they assume leadership early. The lifespan of a chimpanzee in the wild is between 40 to 50 years, and in captivity, they can live longer for about 60 years and above. In chimpanzees, the commonest birth interval is slightly less, being about 3 years most often, commonly 4 years, while anything from 1 year onwards occurs and sexual maturity is reached between 8 to 10 years. Communication. Vocalizations present an area of extreme contrast between gorillas and chimpanzees. Gorillas are generally quiet. They are not physically capable of making the same sound as humans. They generate about 25 distinct noises. Hooting can carry a mile through the forest and is usually exchanged between rival silverbacks. Other vocalizations include screams, grunts indicating contentment, and high-pitched barks indicating curiosity. In keeping with their close human relatives, chimps are among the noisiest of all wild animals and use a complicated system of sound to communicate with each other. A loud roar call, which can be heard more than a mile away, warns of something unusual or disturbing. They hoot, scream, grunt, and drum on hollow trees with the flat of their hands, sometimes for hours. In gorillas, energetic, mischievous youngsters are disciplined with stern vocalizations, body posturing, and strong looks. Gorillas also chuckle, smile, purr to show their emotions. Chimps touch each other a great deal and may kiss when they meet. They also hold hands and groom each other. An adult chimp has a special friend or companion with which it spends a lot of time. Relationship with humans. In relation with humans, gorillas are known to be more dangerous than chimpanzees. Their bluff charges may, on rare occasions, lead to attack. Chimpanzees rarely charge a human. However, adult males, black or gray-backed, often stay behind when the group they were with has fled as a result of an appearance of a human. They sit in a low branch staring at the human, barking sometimes, and look around. If the observer stays put, it may be many minutes before the male leaves, and during this time, he may lay down along the branch with his back to the observer.
Yes, I know, crazy, right? Not the crazy part that we are very closely related, but also the crazy part that a lot of you have been failing to distinguish between these amazing animals.